I made these for Easter and everybody loves them. Now, what do I call them? Fabric balls? Probably. Easter egg holders? Maybe. Because you can put eggs in it. What's your opinion? You can put Easter eggs in it, use it as decoration on your table, or use it as a unique gift for your friends. Hi, I'm Olga from ebook.com. My channel is all about sewing. I'm so glad you are here. In this tutorial, I will show you how to make these fabric balls. The best thing is that this project doesn't take much time, so you can do it even if you don't have much free time at the moment. You will need some sewing skills, but I'm sure that even beginners will be able to do this project. But even if you are an experienced sewist, this project is very good for polishing your sewing skills. You will cut fabric using a simple PDF pattern, bind a circle, sew binding, make buttonholes, use fusible interfacing, and so on. So improve your sewing skills by practicing them in action. And the best part, it's so much fun. If you don't have time to watch the whole video now, press the like button below and this video will be saved in your liked videos folder. And you can come to see it later when you have time. What you will need to sew this egg holder: fabric, fusible interfacing, a piece of ribbon, sewing machine, buttonhole presser foot, regular sewing notions. Template, it's free for subscribers to my newsletter. Check the link below this video. Please watch the whole video before starting the project. Step 1. Prepare all necessary materials for making this fabric ball. Download and print the PDF pattern and assemble it. It's only 4 pages long. Assembling the pattern is pretty easy. Start with your first row, pages 1 and 2. Draw a line like this on page 2. Cut the page 2 along this line and overlap it on page 1. Line up the pattern lines. You will also see this small triangle that will help you line up your pattern even easier. Tape the pages together. When taping, try to keep the pages so they don't shift. After your first row is assembled, continue on with the second row. Align the tops and the sides of your pages. And this is the result. The template is ready. Cut out the circle carefully. Choose your fabric. You can use the same fabric for the whole ball, or you can choose a few different fabrics that match your decor. I used 100% quilting cotton with lovely flower prints. Choose ready-made bias strips or choose fabric for making your own bias strips. I used both for my projects. The bias tape is a decorative element that makes the ball look nicer and more professional. If you make your own bias tape, you may use a wider range of fabrics and match it with the fabric for the ball. Set up your sewing machine. Thread it with matching color thread, try tension on scrap, and so on. Step 2. Cut out the fabric and fusible interfacing for the ball. Cut 6 circles from the fabric of your choice and 6 circles from fusible interfacing. You can either use scissors to cut it out or a rotary cutter. First, place the template on 3 layers of fusible interfacing and cut.
Repeat for another 3 layers of interfacing. I use medium weight usable interfacing from Pelon. Now you can fuse the interfacing to the fabric and after that cut fabric circles one by one. Or you can cut circles from the fabric using the paper template. You can cut 2 circles at once if you fold the fabric and after that fuse the interfacing to the fabric circles. Either way is good. If you want to make your own binding, cut bias strips 40 inches long and 1.5 inches wide. Binding strips must be cut on the bias at 45 degrees angle. If you cut them straight on the grain, you will have problems binding the circles and the circles will not lay flat. I use my cutting mat and a Martelli rotary cutter. I lay the fabric in such a way that the lengthwise grain is exactly parallel to the selvages and the cross grain is perpendicular to the selvages. The grid on my cutting board is really helpful here and I can align the selvage with one of the lines on my cutting board. Smooth the fabric on the board so it's completely flat and there are no bubbles. The slightest bump can skew it. It's easy to cut using the cutting mat's grid. My cutting mat has many diagonal lines at a 45 degrees angle to help me find the bias. Place some pressure on the rotary cutter so it cuts nicely. Step 3. Binding the fabric circles. Place every 2 circles, one on top of the other, wrong sides together. You can secure the 2 layers with pins, but I prefer to use a fabric glue stick. Just rub the stick over the area to be glued. I use 3 different binding strips for my Easter balls. For the white bottom circle and for the pink ball, I made my own binding strips. To start, fold the end of the bias strip, about 3/8 of an inch, like this. Now position the edge of the bias tape along the edge of the fabric, right sides together, and use pins to attach it. Or use wonder clips. Don't stretch the fabric. Work your way all around the circle. Secure the bias strip with pins or wonder clips. Be careful not to stretch the bias edge. When you come to the place where you started, overlap the ends. Don't fold the second end, just place it on the folded end and pin. It's ready for stitching. I like to use a walking presser foot. My Janome machine has a built-in walking foot. It's different from a regular walking foot. Seam allowances are 1/4 inch. Don't sew over pins. Make sure you remove pins or clips when the needle is close to them. When stitching, make sure you don't stretch the fabric. It has to be exactly the opposite. We have to ease the fabric while sewing the bias strip. For this, I like to slightly push the fabric toward the presser foot. Don't do it with your fingers. Use a small stick or even a seam ripper. I'm using a stylus that was supposed to be used with touchscreen devices. Well, it doesn't work with my devices, but I'm often using it with my sewing machine. You really need to ease the fabric when attaching bias strips to circles and curves, otherwise the fabric will stretch and the circle will not stay flat. Now the bias tape is stitched in place, we have to rub the bias strip over the fabric edges of the circle. After that, press it. Now fold the raw edge of the bias strip. The folded edge should just cover the stitches I made attaching the bias strip. Make sure it has the same size all over and doesn't have any pleats or folds. Pin in place on the wrong side of the circle. Press with a hot iron. Use pressing gloves if you iron over pins. After ironing, go to your sewing table and take out the pins from the wrong side and insert them on the right side. We have to prepare the fabric for stitching, and it's better to stitch the binding on the right side. Stitch on the right side of the circle close to the edge. If you correctly folded the edge of the bias strip on the wrong side, you will have nice top stitches on both sides of the circle. I use this technique for binding four circles of the balls. For the other two circles, I used a different bias staple and a different method to attach it. This bias staple is storyboard, and the folded edges have very small seam allowances. So I just place the bias tape over the fabric and make the fold equal on both sides of the circle. But here I will have a problem with overlapping the edges of the tape. I cannot do it as I did with my own binding tape. So I just leave about 3 inches on each end of the bias tape unpinned. I measure where they are supposed to meet, cut the ends perpendicular to the tape and sew the ends together. After that, I press the tape, making sure I have nice folded edges around this small seam. Now I need to stitch the tape in place. But using a regular straight stitch might be a problem because the folded edges are equal on both sides of the circle. And if I sew on the right side, I don't see how it goes on the wrong side. And I might not catch it all the way along. So the solution is simple. Use a zigzag stitch. These are the settings for the zigzag stitch, 3.5 millimeters wide and 1.5 millimeters long. And as you can see, all the edges on both sides of the circle are sewn nicely. Press all the fabric circles after you are done binding. Step 4. Finishing the fabric balls. Now I use the template and mark some stitching lines on the top circle of each ball. For this, cut the template along the side lines that divide the circle into 8 segments. Use a suitable fabric marker to draw the lines. I like to use my friction pen. Marks of this pen are clearly visible on my fabric and will completely disappear with the heat of the iron. Now we need to mark a few openings for the ribbon. I think the openings should be buttonholes. They are essential for this project, so take a ruler and start marking them. Measure 1¾ inch from each point of the octagon in the middle. Connect these new points with straight lines using a ruler. Mark 2 buttonholes 3/8 inch long on each line, about 3/4 inch from each side. You can make buttonholes using a buttonhole foot. This project is great to practice making buttonholes. I guess you can just cut the fabric for inserting ribbon, and it's not going to fray much because it's quilting cotton and it has fusible interfacing on the wrong side. But if you can make buttonholes with your sewing machine, it will look more professionally done. I was experimenting with my embroidery machine and made openings for the ribbon with my embroidery machine. Now place 2 fabric circles, one on top of the other, and stitch along these marked lines. Now the 2 fabric circles are connected. Place them on the 3rd bottom circle and stitch the octagon in the middle. Press over the stitches. If you have used a friction pen, the marks will disappear. Insert the ribbon and make the 3D shape by tying the ribbon.
I hope you found this video helpful, and if you are new to the channel, thank you so much for subscribing and coming over here. If you would like to try making this project, download the template, check the links in the description box. And thanks for watching. See you in the next video.